The important objective of charter change is to shift from a unitary to a parliamentary form of government in various shapes that would govern federal states. It is often claimed that there is a necessity of devolving powers from the central government to federal states. We ask the question, is it necessary to change the charter in order to devolve power? Many constitutional and legal experts do not seem to think so. What is truly needed for a genuine devolution of power, according to them, is a full implementation of the Constitution, the creation of the enabling laws and some revisions of the local government code, and a more decisive effecting of the Indigenous People's Rights Act. Only this, they believe, can ensure that self-determination and decentralization of powers, both political and financial, are in fact realized. Moreover, a major objection to a federal system that devolves power to the federal states on an equal basis will not satisfactorily address the aspirations of the Muslims and humans in Mindanao for self-determination and respect for ancestral rights. Gift of the Spirit, freedom to do good and not evil. St. Paul speaks of freedom that is gift of the Holy Spirit. It is a freedom towards life, not towards death, a freedom not to do evil, but to do good. Political authority is not given and is designed to defend, promote, and ensure what is good. When political power is exercised for this task, it fulfills what God intends with his gift. There the Spirit of God operates, and there the freedom of God's children flourishes. When political authority comes to do what is good, there the Spirit of God is absent. We should not then be surprised when properly formed consciences declare in the mind of Peter and the other apostles, we must obey God rather than men. Conclusion. Discern, decide, and act within Mary, with Mary our mother. We call upon you, dear people of God, to form or reactivate circles of discernment and use your freedom as God's children to discern, participate, discuss, and debate. Have an informed conscience and decide the right of the gospel values. Do what is necessary. Persuade our legislators to do not only what is genuinely for the good of all, this issue of charter change. We trust this urgent moral task that seriously impacts the future of our nation with the intercession of the Blessed Mother, the Virgin Mary, Reina, and the Venus, for the Catholic Bishops, Patroness of the Philippines, Archbishop Aramoro G. Valdez, Archbishop Davao, President of CBC, Agent of 29, 28, and Davao City. So you have to reflect. Ngayon ang masyadong mahaba. Tapos ito, ita-translate sa Tagalog. Ipapadala yung translator sa Tagalog, ang official translator ay si Bishop Ray. Ang tanong, paano ito makarating sa mga mananampalataya? Kasi kung ito'y papasahin at tulad ng binasa kayo, yung mga mananampalataya ay nasa target na ito lang ay tulungin na. So, if you could think of, siguro, ang hindi lahat mabasahe, kundi yung mga main points, ganun lang. Para, kasi, minsan, kung basahin lang eh, hindi ang gagawin natin. Kung ano yung pinakamahalaga, yun. Yun ang pagnataan sa dinami-dami. That's one. Second, ay, ito pa mga decision ay dahil sa decision of virgin consecrated persons, meron tayong directory for the ministry of life of Christ. Meron kayo nito dahil mga 2 or 3 Christmas na ito, binigyan ko kayo nito. Ito yung may spiral. Kung binasa nyo hindi, hindi nasa inyo. Pero makikipan ulit, makikipasa ulit. At magkakaroon na yun ay universal para sa mong simbahan. Magkakaroon tayo ng national directory para sa ating mismo entity. It will mean a lot of work para sa ating. Thirdly, ay yung ratio, may bagong ratio. Ang gagawin dito sa atin, ayun ay meron na kasi tayong dating graduate yung UBTF. Yung aayusin lang yun at pag-aayusin yung dalawa para maging guide sa seminary formation. Ang napakaganda pala sa seminary formation at yun ang i-elaborate sa inyo mamaya. Eh, klaro. Klaro, pero yung pasimula, probiotic, ibigyan ng pansin, magiging isang mabuting Kristiyano, yan. Tapos sunod na yung pagiging disipulo ng Kristo sa ateis. Tapos pagdating ng theology, ilang disipulo, magiging kapulat ng Kristo. Pagkatapos ng theology, kumikilos ka na, nakatulad ng Kristo sa pastoral aspect. Yan. At sinasabi dito, in fact, itong sinya reformation, ito iusapan ni Pusa Party sa gabi, yung cocktail na ito, dahil yung tunay na pagkain, yung system, ating buhay. So, ito yung pinag-pita ko ang yung reformators. At so far, yung, actually, ang naging pag talaga doon ay yung bago fraction, yung layos. And then, the later part, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, ito yung meeting namin na isa sa mga paras ka itong pastor agenda. Yun na. Salamat po, sir. Meron lang ilang minuto pa, baka meron immediately nagpapakam na question.